Think there's a fly in that drink? Think again. That's the trendiest cocktail this side of science. Last fall, MIT researchers made news for developing this moving cocktail boat and a pipette that looks like a water lily. Both garnishes play with surface tension, a special property of liquids. The project is a collaboration with renowned chef José Andrés, a lecturer at Harvard's Science and Cooking course. To see how their ideas are moving from the lab to the kitchen and bar, we visited Andrés' headquarters, ThinkFoodGroup, in Washington, D.C. Research and Development Director Ruben García says the challenge is about more than making things safe to eat.
Not only edible, something that it tastes good. The idea can be great, but at the end, everything ends in the same place, which is in your mouth.
But that doesn't mean exotic ingredients.
So the boat and the flour, they're made from gelatin, vegetable gelatin that you can find in the supermarket.
The edible flour pipette works best in cold liquids, where the gelatin can't dissolve. But when conditions are right, it works just like the original. Meanwhile, ThinkFoodGroup's cocktail innovator, Juan Coronado, is kicking the cocktail boat up a notch. He makes them with raspberry gelatin and a touch of Saint-Germain elderflower liqueur. Like the flour, these boats come from silicone molds with help from a 3D printer. Also like the flour, they work best at cold temperatures. Coronado pre-chills his glassware. Coronado's cocktail contains elderberry cordial for color and flavor. He's dropping a high-proof alcohol like Bacardi 151 into the boat. The boat runs on the same fuel as the original, surface tension.
The difference between the ABVs of the two alcohols, the one that I'm adding to the boat and the one that is already on the cocktail, is what causes the cocktail to propel. When you were kids, you know, I don't know if you ever put like a little piece of paper in your bathtub and then the soap, and you know, it creates that tension as well.
Grown-ups will have to be patient. These prototypes aren't at restaurants yet. ThinkFoodGroup is always on the lookout for science that inspires. Just don't tell them that this work is molecular gastronomy.
It's not molecular gastronomy. All gastronomy is molecular.
For Chemical and Engineering News, I'm Carmen Drawl.